Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We didn't have really strong seismic activity. If you look at the last 2 weeks or so, only two major or strong earthquakes, magnitude 6.9 and 6.5. 6.9 occurred on the 2nd of July, and then nothing much happened. We also didn't have planetary conjunctions very much. Then, as you can see here on the SGI graph, on the 6th, we had a clustering of magnitude 5.8 earthquakes, and then on the 10th, a 6.5 North Atlantic Ocean, just outside the Caribbean plate. And accompanied by magnitude 5.7, Southern East Pacific rise, also some more clustering there, some stronger seismic activity, typically magnitude 5.6 and larger. And then on the 14th, we had a 6.3 near the coast of Chiapas, Mexico. And as you can see, the seismic increase in the clustering typically occurs with clustering of planetary geometry. Only one planetary conjunction, as I mentioned in the previous forecast, that happened on the 10th. And we see the strongest earthquake right there, also later on the 10th. If we look at the next period, that's the next 9 or 10 days, from the 15th to the 24th, we see this here on the SGI graph. I labeled the planetary geometry and the lunar geometry, and as you can see, we have a lot more planetary conjunctions coming up. Tonight already, two planetary conjunctions involving Mercury. These are the higher red peaks, Mercury, Sun, Neptune, that will be tonight at 21:44 UTC, and followed by Sun, Mercury, Mars early on the 16th at 2:48 UTC. And then on the 17th, we have Mars, Mercury, Neptune. So as you can see, we have Mercury, Mars, the Sun and Neptune in a near quadruple conjunction in the next couple of days. And then on top of that, we also have on the 18th coming up, this is the purple peak, that is Mars, Venus, Saturn on the 18th at 9:19 in the morning UTC. And then also, finally, I should say, on the 20th, Mars, Earth, Saturn. And that will be on the 20th at 2015 UTC. So we have a series of planetary conjunctions. This is 3, 4, 5 actually, up until the 20th. And we are probably going to see a seismic increase. If it's going to be a lot of magnitude, higher 5 magnitude, I'm not sure. A couple of 6s, maybe even a magnitude 7. This is a clustering of planetary conjunctions, so we should see a seismic increase. How exactly that is going to take shape, that is the question. We have to wait and see, but expect a seismic increase following these planetary conjunctions in the next couple of days. We also have lunar geometry coming up, especially on the 17th, where Mars and Saturn will be closest in the geometry with the Moon. That will be at 6:23 UTC in the morning, 45 degrees, and with the Moon and Saturn, that will be at 11:04. So that will be in the morning of the 17th, 135 degrees and 45 degrees. This is also pretty critical. It's probably the closest that the lunar geometry will be with Mars and Saturn. I will show you in a minute in the solar system. And then we have on the 21st a high lunar peak, that is a conjunction with Saturn and Mars. And as you can see, by then Mars has just passed Saturn in the geometry. And we're probably going to have a critical time ahead the next 2 weeks in July, and then especially in August, as I mentioned earlier already in the previous forecast with Neptune. That's going to be very critical. But this is the high lunar peak on the 21st due to the double conjunction with Mars and Saturn. And this is because, as you can see, Earth is practically exactly between Mars and Saturn at the time on 20th, 21st. So we had the planetary conjunction Mars, Earth, Saturn on the 20th, and followed almost in a convergence with the lunar conjunctions with also with Saturn and Mars. So this is also going to be critical. And then finally, at the end, on the 23rd and 24th, we have the typical pair of 90 degree angles with Mercury, Venus and Uranus. And the last three times that this happened, it was in May, in January and in September 22, we had mid-7 magnitude earthquakes following that particular geometry. I will discuss that in the next update when we get there, because that is very interesting but also very critical geometry. If we look at the solar system, we see the planetary conjunctions in the next couple of days. Mars is a key player, And then we see here the near quadruple conjunction with Mars, Mercury, the Sun, and Neptune. And then also, as you can see, Venus and Earth are very close between Mars and Saturn. That's what we're going to have in the next couple of days. I expect a seismic increase. Maybe it's going to be a clustering of higher 5-magnitude earthquakes. There are probably going to be one or two strong earthquakes, maybe more, with this planetary geometry. I expect a mid-6, maybe a higher 6-magnitude earthquake with the Mars-Earth-Saturn conjunction. And other than that, we'll have to wait and see how it turns out, but expect a seismic increase. It's probably going to be more seismically active than we've seen in the last 2 weeks. If we look at the atmospheric fluctuations, this is updated regularly on the website. I will take the two latest fluctuations that we recorded. That was on the 12th, and it marked regions over Africa, but also the Mediterranean or Italy, Greece. It's probably not going to take long before stronger seismic activity is going to occur in that region. It could also be more to the north, the Balkan region, and maybe even Romania. In 1941, the last time, there was a magnitude 7.8 earthquake in Romania, but very deep. Almost always these major and large earthquakes in Romania, they are almost always about 100 kilometers deep at the Carpathian Mountains. So, but it will be felt widely if that is going to happen, and it will happen again. We don't know when exactly it is going to be, so we keep track here with the atmospheric fluctuations. They can be an important indicator. And then also on the 13th, the West Pacific regions, also a very clear atmospheric fluctuation, marking these regions over Indonesia to the North Philippines, Taiwan, maybe, and perhaps Japan, I'm not sure, and then more to the north, China, maybe Mongolia. From time to time, there can be stronger seismic activity as well. So you can look up the latest fluctuations on the website, and also the latest forecast and the magnitude probability. Check them out regularly. This is the update for now. Be on watch in the coming week, because we have a bunch of planetary conjunctions coming up, and they may trigger a pretty strong seismic activity, especially because of the position of Earth between Mars and Saturn. Stay safe. Until next time.